August 1839. I can't stop sweating and shaking. The warding ritual was not something of a sane mind. I did not even realize the dungeon was still in use. Alexander had his servants bring one of the prisoners, a murderer, he told me. Alexander made all the arrangements, but he said I had to perform the ritual in order to have the right effect. The shadow could be led astray by the blood of another. Killing the man would provide us precious time. What else could I do? Alexander said it had to be done. He is saving my life. I don't have the luxury of argument.
Stay awake. Can you feel the syringe?
No. I can't feel anything, Alexander.
Yes?
Soon, I won't even be able to move, will I?
Your life is safe.
I don't doubt that. But will it be worth living? Alexander? Oh my, so Babylon shall fall, you say? You hurry too much. Alexander is toothless without an awe.
He has one. That's not very promising at all. The sanctum is basically impenetrable, but guess the white hole.
It could be breached by another, but Alexander broke his.
I mean, my all, a long time ago.
Really? Well, if you tell the truth, by all means, seek out the pieces of the broken orb and mend away. I believe he uses them for torture now. They practically leak matter, which is quite useful, I understand. There should be 6 of them. Look around the choir and the transept. You should be able to find them there.
I know this. I've been here already. I know this taste. A taste of Damascus Rose obfuscating the truth in a dim haze. They may sweep the traces from my memory, but my body remembers. These cuts speak volumes, even though my mind remains silent. They will be back. They will be back.
something.
What do you mean?
Never mind. Your intuition is remarkable.
I'm not sure I'm following.
It doesn't matter. It's just a myth, after all.
Banishment ritual is taking longer than expected, and we have to do what is needed. I spend my time helping out the prisoners. Being around these degenerates makes me ill. None of them even tries to face their punishment with any kind of dignity. They taunt me with their lies of innocence and their cowardly pleas of mercy. What can make a man fall so far from the grace of a civilized existence? They are all wicked men, and I remind myself of it constantly. Still, I am thankful for God sending these monsters our way, as they will serve as the instruments of my salvation. I try to study the different tools in the torture chamber and learn how to use them effectively. Last time was messy, and the effect suffered from my inexperience. When the next warding is to be performed, I shall be ready.
how you repay me? How dare you?
Are meant to hold prisoners who are under treatment. The people you send for will end up here. Remember that the confinement itself works as a preamble to the torture, and you should pace yourself. Don't take anyone before they are ready.
Understood.
Sounds from the torture chambers are shuttled in through those pipes in the ceiling. Manage your victims well, and let one prisoner's pain instill terror in his cellmate.
Daddy, I hate to bother you further, but if you're really going after Alexander, would you consider taking me with you? I know it sounds ridiculous. I mean, look at me. But if you find anything concerning a man named Johann Weil, would you please bring it to me? I believe he was working on a way to help me. A recipe for some sort of potion, a tonic to free me from this husk of mine.
Many of Alexander's things are breaking down. Look around. Maybe the other room. There are machine parts hidden all over this place. You'll find a way to fix it.
To me, I'm Heinrich Cornelius Agrippa. And this one's quite important, you know. Baron Alexander has sustained my soul in this dead husk for years. Who knows how many? Hundreds, I presume. How are things coming?
But he has grown impatient.
Thank you.
Dad, good to see you.
Why me? I'm the next best thing. Alexander really vied it. None other than Johann Weyer. You never heard of Johann Weyer?
My God, boy. He's probably the greatest man in history. And you don't know him? Or is it the world who has forgotten him?
Yes, I do take pride in that. Is it so wrong?
How are things coming?
I found the Mithraea plants. Van which had not been plundered. Do you know Mithraea? Well, I suppose it doesn't matter. It is an old thing, building temples out of caverns. The Dark Walls being the humans. Inside are its followers. Humans watching the sky slowly turn. But the followers do have one theme to allow them a real sense of connection, creation. The orbs. Not many orbs are left. They sometimes consume themselves or break.
then used by an uninitiated. I was lucky. The orb I found spared my life and returned to where I found it. I know because Alexander took it and brought it to Brennerland. He unearthed a number of cavern temples and gathered a whole collection of orbs. But unlike every other finder since the fall of the Misrae Fane, he was able to unshackle the horror. You and I connected with the orbs. He used them and was able to travel far and wide beyond the world itself. I've done all that I can to escape this prison, but now I use all my strength merely to stay alive. My pupil, Johann Weyer, said he'd found a way to take me with him beyond the stars. But I was too afraid to come home. Simply. And now, all I can do is regret it. I've always hoped Fire would return and give me a second chance. But so does Alexander. The door's open? Good going. I knew you could do it. Thank you.
much more, Baron? How much more am I supposed to withstand? Kill me already! Kill me!
This one. Prepare him.
cradle is ready.
Good.
You're a man! How can you partake in this?
Is he all right?
He is one of the wicked. Don't pay his lies any attention.
I'm not a bad man! It was an accident!
He set a man on fire.
It wasn't my fault! Why won't anyone listen?
That's horrible.
Of course. We are dealing with monsters here.
Thank you.
15th of August, 1839. The blood wards are failing. The shadow beckons, and its cry disarms my actions. Hurry, no time to spare. You have to kill another. Alexander produces a knife. He wants me to cut the flesh. Do it. Save yourself. He is a murderer, Daniel. He is evil. A cold-blooded killer. Hurry!
Alexander, you must let me be.
I have to concentrate. Take the man. Cut the lines. Cut the flesh. Watch the blood spill. Let it come.
Please, I didn't do anything.
Paint the man, cut the lines. Paint the man, cut the lines. Leave the man cries. Ah, ah, now you see. I did well. One life for another. You hear me, guardian of the orb? I did all this for you. Now, once more, withdraw your shadow from my domain. Alexander. There isn't much time. I can feel it. We must act swiftly. I will do whatever it takes.
The wheel is good for keeping your victim still during the procedure. They can be bound around the circumference or simply stretched across, tying limbs to the spokes and rim. All tools are by this point useful, and you may administer the torture in any way you like. But the forte of the wheel is the gaps. When you have decided that the victim shall die, you can smash their limbs with a hammer, making them fold in between the frame.
But they'll die. Too quickly, I mean.
No, don't worry. The human body is much more resilient. They can survive for days until they finally succumb.
Incredible. You found Vaya's recipe. Then there might still be a chance. Listen carefully. Alexander is working on opening a gate, a door to another world. It's where he wants to go. If you could put your anger aside, let him open the portal before you take your revenge. Let me pass the gate then. Please, find the ingredients and prepare the tonic via disguise. And do so before you assemble the orb. The barrier keeping you from the inner sanctum will only be breached for a short time. Unless everything is taken care of before mending the orb, you won't be able to save me. Anything of you. But if you could find it in your heart to gather the ingredients for Vaya's tonic before attempting to mend the orb, there might still be a chance for you to save me. Please, my faith is in your hands. You have all the orb pieces you need. I know I have no right to ask anything of you, but if you could find it in your heart to gather the ingredients for Vaya's tonic before I... attempting to mend the orb, there might still be a chance for you to save me. Please.
Amnesia mixture? It does explain so much of your behavior. You never did finish what you set out to do. You talked about redemption. How you would face the Orb's shadow and save our work and me. I will grant you another chance to redeem yourself. You can wait here and stop the shadow. Thank you, friend.
20th of August, 1839. Tonight, we will unlock the power of the orb and ultimately banish the shadow hunting me. I feel it closing in on me, and I fear for my life more than ever. Just outside Altstadt lies a small settlement where Zimmermann, a dairy farmer, lives with his wife and three children. We took the coach and went there. Our visit was unexpected, and Alexander was able to strike Zimmermann down without alerting the others. As he went to take care of the farmhands, I began to look for the children. We should have more than enough prisoners to finish the ritual now.
thought I'd lost you. The castle crumbled, and I could hear the chancel collapse. The laboratory might be accessible now. What are you doing? Time is running short. Time is running short. Running short. time is running short. You conquered, but I believe you have more important things to take care of. No time for sitting around. What are you doing?
Don't get ahead of yourself. First, we need the tonic. Time is running short.
Believe what I have become. One of the girls escaped and I chased after her all the way upstairs. I hunted her down and what is her life worth? How many lives can I take before I surrender my own? Sure, I would kill a murderer to save an innocent, but to kill an innocent to save myself? A cold-blooded murderer.
Thank you.
time is running short. Time is running short. What are you doing? Time is running short.
You're a good boy, Dinah. And I appreciate your company. But I believe you have more important things to take care of. You should hurry, Daniel. No time for sitting around.